later.
You can't condemn me to exile on one primitive planet in one century in time. Besides, I'm known on the Earth. It might be very awkward for me.
Your appearance has changed before. It will change again, and that is part of the sentence.
You can't just change what I look like without consulting me.
I had to face my fear, sir. I had to face my fear. That was more important than this going on living.
Please.
I was going to take you to so many places.
And why can't we go?
Every cell in my body's dying.
Why can't you do something?
Live too long.
No. No, no, please. Please don't. No, don't. Don't. Please don't. Please.
Wilfred. It's my honor.
Better be quick.
3, 2, 1.
It's all over. That's what you said. But it isn't all over. It's far from being all over.
No more epic way to end a series or a movie or something like that than killing off a beloved main character. And even that, it's not as how much if you kill him or not, as how you kill him, if he has a really good killing, you have the best ending ever. And if you have a bad killing, you will have the worst ending ever. And in Doctor Who is such a blessed series that you actually can kill up only not only just a main character but the main character. And they had quite a lot of practice, as they so far had 9 killings, not counting the 8th Doctor, because we didn't see how he died.
The good thing is he's not dead for long. I get to kill him again!
So here is my top 9 best Doctor Who, the Doctor killer. Why top 9? Because there's only 9 deaths, damn it, I just told you. Death number 1. Death of the 7th Doctor, Sylvester McCoy. There is no excuse for this killing, none at all. They had the budget, they had the time, they had the script writing. Actually, what kind of better if they just had let him out? What happens is basically this, he lands with the TARDIS, somebody is shooting at the TARDIS, and he is stupid enough to walk out, not even checking if there's somebody outside, and he gets shot. It would be bad enough just ending there to having been shot and killed by that, because at least you can say if you get shot and killed by that, you are kind of hardcore, kind of. But then he get on the operation table and he dies doing operation. It's the worst possible way to go. I mean, this is a lord of time. Not only a time lord, the time lord. A lord of time, traveling the universe, saved the earth hundreds of times and already have died 6 times beforehand. And then he goes having himself killed on an operating table. I'm not a doctor, by all means, I'm not a doctor, but I'm fairly sure the doctor doesn't normally stick probes into people's hearts to check why it's not beating right. Perhaps they will just wait some time, take some scans, take some blood tests, I don't know, but sticking really expensive equipment in there and calling in the best heart surgeon they've got to remove some bullets? Dying on the operation table. Death by banana, it's much cooler. At least that's memorable.
You will never get me, banana! I will get the insane video fine.
Death number 2. Death of the Sixth Doctor, Colin Baker. The only reason why Disney has to have the number 1 spot is because they have an excuse for this. They have the excuse that they simply didn't have the actor. What happened was that Colin Baker actually wanted to stay on the show for several years trying to outlive Tom Baker, not outlive Tom Baker, but being there in at least 7 years like Tom Baker. But he was the first actor since William Hartnett to be booted out, and he was quite pissed by that, which is kind of understandable. He got the blame from the plumbing viewers in the show, not the writers, as it should perhaps should have been. And because of that, he refused to go back to doing a regeneration episode, and I totally understand him. I'm totally dealing with him, and so they had to do something to explain this regeneration, and they had the TARDIS being shooting a bit at from the exterior. You just seen the exterior being shooting at from somewhere, you don't know where, and he bumped his head on the TARDIS console and it triggered regeneration apparently. So they had one very unintentional hilarious scene in the TARDIS where Sylvester McCoy, the Seventh Doctor, which is a very small man, while Colin Baker is kind of a big man, sort of a beer, kind of a beery man, nice and plumbing about and scary if he wants to. So Sylvester McCoy, who is this very small man, is looking on the floor with the most fake looking wig in history. I'm trying to look like Colin Baker and it's just ridiculous. But the death is ridiculous, laughable, but as I said, they have an excuse. They didn't have the actor. Still, I don't think it quite excuses this death, that it is so bad. It would just have taken kind of an imaginative writer to do it differently. It could like be that male, the companion, is sitting alone, brooming, saying, where is the doctor? He's been gone for quite some time and don't know where he's been gone. And then the doctor returns as Sylvester McCoy and he can tell some kind of really grim story about I am being there and that and that and that happened and I saw him die and I died and blah 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 blah. And problem solved. It wouldn't be really good. It would be bad no matter what you do, but it wouldn't be that bad as raising Sylvester McCoy in that ridiculous wig. Oh no! Oh no! It's the mutant banana!